thought they were the more physical team. I thought they were the more desperate team, determined team, better coach team, better players. You know, we got to figure out what's wrong with us. I like my team, but obviously there's some things missing that I have to correct. I've been saying this for a couple of games. I got to do a better job. The players got to do a better job. But, you know, you got to give Rhode Island a lot of credit. Their kids played well. They outscrapped us in every way. They deserved to win. We did not deserve to even be in the building. You know, that was a piss poor performance. I'm very, very disappointed in our group, but I'm more disappointed in myself, and hopefully I can do a better job the next time we play, which is in a week, which we need some time to regroup, have some meetings with our players. You know, it's frustrating when you got a group that you know is talented, a group that is really, really good men. Whatever reason, we're just not clicking right now, and it's my job to find out. I'm not going to put our head down. I'm not going to use any excuses. Best thing to do is let the players up. Let them know it'll be okay. There's a lot of games left to play. But today, if you had to Coach Cox and his team, they were prepared. They did a really good job, so congratulations to them.
Is it going to be tough to win any game with 22 turnovers? That's the season I've
had. You know, we can play 5-on-0 if it's 22 turnovers. We have a tough time for it. You know, it's inexcusable for us to score 60 points against, you know, six dudes. Six, seven guys. So we got to get better at it.
Did you sense frustration building in the first half? How did you get 13 in the first half?
Not frustration. You know, we give them credit on defense. They ran the passing lanes. You know, they did a good job scouting. You know, they were more determined. They had a lot more energy and effort defensively. And we did. We were lackluster. I promise you that we will fix that. 1,000,000%. We will fix what's going on.
Which part?
Everything.
Yeah. What did you try to do, Ed, coming in with Bats Russell? And just how tough was he to just?
I mean, he's a great player. I mean, you know, we're going to play against great players every game. Each school has them. They have their go-to guys. And when they play well, they're going to win. When he doesn't play well, they're going to struggle. Same thing with us. When our guys play well, when our frontline guys play well, we're successful. When they don't, we struggle. That's any team in the country. But he played really well. Good player. He's really improved. You guys should be really, really happy. The coaches have done a great job with his emotional well-being, his player development. Really, really good player.
Did you feel like you found something in the paint in the second half when you cut the deficit down to the paint there?
We found a lot in the paint. We had to get it in there without giving it to the opposing team. You know, Christmas came early for many of them because we just gift-wrapped like 15 to 18 points right in their hands. So Santa Claus is definitely living here in Kingston.
Is it fair to say if the season is going to turn around, it's going to largely depend on the play of the seniors?
No. It's going to depend on the play of every player in that organization. I have to be a better coach. In order for us to turn around, I have to be a better coach. It's really that simple. It's not the players. It's on me. I got to do a better job organizing them, giving them more confidence, and putting them in positions to be successful. And the ones who aren't playing are going to have an opportunity to do so. I may be playing the wrong dudes, to be honest with you.
Kalif, can you speak to the frustration level?
I think we always take it one game at a time. I think that this one was definitely a tough one because it obviously came with a lot of emotion, a lot of anxiety in a good way to try and come and get a win here. But I think we're just taking it game by game. I think we got to take it a little more serious. But I think for me as a senior, I got to step up as well.
Kalif, you guys got off to a good start, at least on the offensive glass. Could you sense that there was a chance to maybe push that lead a little bit more?
I think I trust all my guys. I think that made some things happen, but I think that we got bullied on the offensive glass on the other side. You know, we allowed them to really take it to us in a sense after we kind of started off to a good start. But I think that it's a bit of I'm more frustrated with myself and how we played at this point. I think we could have done a lot better, but it's okay. We're going to figure it out.
And you got it to two. You got a turnover here or there and a few bad shots. I think there was 1-3 out of a timeout. I mean, is that guy's not listening or just trying to, you know, hero ball, as Doc Rivers used to say?
I don't know if I want to call it a hero ball. I think listening is a great skill. And then some of our guys need to go back to class on listening. You know, and maybe I'm not giving the right directive. Before we point a finger at anybody, you always got to take self-accountability. You know what I mean? Do I got to speak louder? Do I have to be more demanding in the huddle? We're really, really good coming out of timeouts. That's one of the things we pride ourselves on nationally. We're really good. whatever reason, we just didn't execute coming out of them, you know. We had opportunities to make layups, miss layups, free throws. It all ties in. The game's really long. It's a really, really long game, and it's going to be ebbs and flow of the game. And, you know, I think they had like maybe a 9-0, 10-0 run, you know, when the game was close. It was a tough offensive foul that was called, which was probably the correct call, but that really ignited them, and I think they had 3 out of 6 possessions where they made threes. So when you're giving up threes like that, with emotion in the building like this, you know, I really hope the fans that, because I'll cheer for the University of Rhode Island moving forward, you know, I hope this room is the same thing when any other school comes in here to play, because these kids will cheat this team out of a successful season only. They should pack this building every single day. These kids, these administrators deserve that, and not just to come when it's so-called a big game. Every game's a big game, every single game. And if they have this amount of energy and emotion, they're gonna be a very hard team to beat in here. And I hope the students hear that, and all your season ticket holders hear that as well. Don't cheat this team out. They have a chance to have a successful season.